Let's talk about how to install Ambari on Ubuntu. So as you know, Ambari's main purpose is to install, deploy, manage and monitor Hadoop clusters. And more or less, Ambari is quite similar to the Cloudera versions of Cloudera Manager. So without much delay, let's get into the installation steps on the required software. So the required software and the installation steps, a minimum of 50 GB is suggested and 8 GB of RAM. However, you can go with a minimum of 4 GB, but your system is going to be very slow. Second is to set up SSH. Third is to download the JDK 1.7 or 1.8. We'll see how to set that up automatically. Then set up a host name. Fifth one is set up passwordless SSH so that Ambari can execute its agents automatically by logging in. Next is disable the firewall. Next is stop or remove the security enhanced Linux. The next one is download Ambari repository and download the Ambari itself. And finally, we'll start the Ambari server and hit the URL and check if the server is up and running. So let's get started. So first one is to switch to the root user, because we are going to execute most of the tasks as root user. Let's install SSH. So let's go ahead and install this. Okay, once SSH is installed, next step is to make some changes to the sshdconf. Open etc ssh sshdconfig. Go to permit root login. And instead of prohibit password, make it as yes. Okay, so once this is done, next step is to start the SSH service, SSH restart. Okay, so our SSH service is running. So next is install the JDK. So let's see if we have any JDK version. So we'll just add a repository, add apt repository. PPA UPD 18 slash Java. So let's do an apt get update. So after you run the apt get update, now let's run apt get install Oracle Java 8 installer. Hit yes just to accept the license. And this one is going to download the Java JDK. So as you can see, our download is completed and it's extracting and updating the respective packages. So post this, let's verify the Java installation if it's successful. So now let's go back and set this as a default JRE in our system. Okay, so let's verify our Java installation and the version. Okay, so it's fine. Now let's go back and set up the Java home and JRE home. So we'll also set the Java home on the terminal so that Ambari is able to find it. So let's move on to the next step of setting our hostname and setting up FQDN. Let's verify our current hostname. So before setting up the hostname, let's find out the IP using IP address show. Okay, so let's go back. This is hostname. So I'm going to change it to yoda-ambardiserver.com. Save it. Then do the same modifications to etc hosts. ambardiserver.com. Now let's also set up a hostname on the command line. So now let's verify hostname and hostname hyphen f. That looks good. Next, let's generate the SSH keys as root. Generate our SSH keys, SSH keygen. Just accept the defaults. Now let's go to /root.ssh. Cat id rsa dot pub to authorize keys. Okay, so once this is done, try to log in as root onto the same system and see if it works. So this is a SSH, passwordless SSH. So first time it's going to ask yes or no. So as you see, we didn't provide any password. We are able to log in automatically. Now let's close it. So next step is to disable the firewall connection. Let's check the status, UFW status. So it's already inactive. It's fine. Next is, let's check the armor status, app armor, and stop it. App armor status. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll just stop it. Etc init.d app armor stop. Okay, so this service is stopped. Okay, so next the important step is to add the Ambari repository. So as you know, the default Ambari website doesn't support Ubuntu. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a repository from the Hortonworks. So they do support for Ubuntu versions 14, 16, and 18. So let me put out the URL for you guys. Okay, next is to add the Hortonworks repository for Ambari on Ubuntu. So don't worry about the commands. I'm going to put them in the video description. Now let's pull the keys and from the Ubuntu server. So once this is done, let's do the apt-get update. So this is going to add the new Ambari repository also into this. Okay, so as you see here, we get an error that this particular repository is not signed, and you also get a GPG error. So we are just going to do a small workaround for this. Just open etc apt sources.list.d Ambari.list. So here just go to the second line and add trusted equal to s. So once this is done, go back and do an apt-get update. Now let's check. Now let's just check if we are able to search the package names for Ambari. Okay, so as you can see, now it's able to pull up the dependencies for Ambari, OpenSSL, Postgres, Python, etc. Similarly, we can also do that for agent and Ambari metrics assembly. Okay, so once these are in place, let's go back and hit the installation of Ambari. So as you can see, it's going to download some software, which is basically Postgres clients and the server, plus the Python. It's around 753 MB. So as you see now, our Ambari server is being downloaded and being installed along with the Postgres and other libraries. So as you see now, our Postgres is also installed along with the Ambari server. Let's go back and check if our Postgres is up and running. Yes, it is up. Now let's execute the next step of setting up Ambari. Just type ambari-server setup. And this is going to ask for the JDK path. So if you already have it installed, just give the path, choose custom JDK, which is option 3. Otherwise, if you give 1 or 2, it's going to download it from the internet. So as you can see, now our Ambari server setup is completed. Let's go ahead and start the Ambari server. Now let's check the status of the Ambari server. So as you can see, it's up and running. Now let's check the status of Ambari server on the browser. Put your server name colon 8080. So it's going to be yoda-ambariserver.com. Once you get the login page, just go back and add the username as admin and password as admin. So as you can see now, we are able to launch our Apache Ambari on Ubuntu successfully. In the next video, we are going to launch the install wizard and see how to install Hadoop, Spark, Tez, Uzi, HBase, Pig, etc. Before you leave, I'd like to tell you an important information. I have also tied up with Simply Learn and Edureka to bring discounts on live one-on-one courses and live lessons on Big Data, Spark, Python, Java, and lots of other courses. So these discounts and cashbacks range between 20 to 30%, and I have provided the links in this video description along with the period of validity. So make sure to check those out if you are interested. And also, if you like this video, please don't forget to share the video link to your friends, and also don't miss out to subscribe.